नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट स्टैंडर्ड 6 सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 9 द अर्थ अवर हैबिटेट। स्टूडेंट, वी ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड अवर 3 पार्ट्स। नाउ टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विथ लॉन्जिट्यूड्स। The vertical imaginary lines drawn on the surface of the earth are called longitude. In the last video also we learned what is latitude and longitude. Here also picture given, the vertical means standing line given, vertical lines given and drawn on the surface of the earth are called longitude. The longitude meets each other, here and here they are meet each other at the poles. It is north pole and here downside it is south pole. So there are two poles and they meet each other. These lines come to closer to each other while going towards the poles. When they are going from north pole to south pole, they are meet each other. There are total 360 lines longitudes, among which 0 longitude and 180 longitude are important. Now next one is linear circle. The north-south straight line connecting the imaginary surface of the original liner to the earth axis at the same angular distance along the earth surface is called linear circle. Linear circle means semicircle. So north and south straight line connecting to imaginary surface original liner of the earth the same angular distance along with the earth surface, this is the same distance, so this one called semicircle. Notice that there is a horizontal line drawn in the center of the earth surface, it is equator. So here we can see that there is a horizontal means slipping line here is drawn and that one called equator. The equator divides earth into two equal parts. So here is line but it is in the middle of the circle. So it make equal two part, north part and south part. So this is the middle line and it make exact two part of the earth. The portion above equator is called northern hemisphere and portion toward the south equator is called southern hemisphere. So here upper side, this part is called northern hemisphere and downside, this is south part, this one called southern hemisphere. Thus latitudes in its north are called northern latitudes and those towards south are called southern latitudes. So here which part coming equator upper side, that all part called northern latitude and south part equator's downside, this part all are called like a southern hemisphere. So south are called southern latitudes. It is 23.5 latitudes in the northern hemisphere is called Tropic of Cancer, while 23.5 south latitudes in the southern hemisphere is called Tropic of Capricorn. Here also we can see northern part it is 23 point latitudes, this one are called northern hemisphere, that one is called Tropic of Cancer. Here we can see 23.5 north latitudes, this one is called Tropic of Cancer. And here while 23.5 south, here is also 23.5 south latitudes, this one called Tropic of Capricorn. Similarly 66.5 latitude in the north of equator is called Arctic Circle and 66.5 latitudes in the south of equator is called Antarctic Circle. Here we can see 66.5 north latitude, that one is called Arctic Circle, and while 66 point south latitude, this one is called Antarctic Circle. The speed of the sun between Tropic of Cancer in the north and Tropic of Capricorn in the south of equator is called solstice. Solstice, the meaning of this word solstice means either of the two times of the year at which the sun reaches its highest or lowest point in the sky, midday, marked by the longest or shorter day. So that one is called solstice. Therefore, the circle between these are called solstices. It makes 6 months for the speed of the sun. Earth is tilted at a corner 23.5. The sun rays fall almost straight between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Here we can see also with the picture. Here is also North Pole and South Pole. So the sun rays come to the straight line. Straight line between the Tropic of Capricorn and Tropic of Cancer. To understand this longitude and latitude and equator, we will see a video for it. Now our next topic is GPS, Global Positioning System. With the help of Global Positioning System, we come to know the longitudinal and latitudinal location of any place through mobile phones and Google Earth. The latitudinal and longitudinal location of any place may be found with the help of mobiles which have internet access. Today, latitudes, longitudes can easily be understood with this. So, in short, we can say global positioning system. For this, to know the latitude and longitude, so we can learn everything through the mobile phone. And a student in mobile phone, we have a internet access. So with the help of internet and mobile, we can search everything from the Google. So today's life, longitude and latitude can be easily be understood with the help of mobile and internet. Next topic is major longitudes. First one, Greenwich Mean Time, means GMT line. The 0 degree longitude which pass through Greenwich City of England is called Greenwich line. Greenwich line divides Earth into two equal parts from east to west, which is known as the Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. The longitudes up to 180 degree eastern of Greenwich line are called eastern longitude, and the longitude up to 180 degree west of Greenwich lines are called western longitude. The Greenwich means time is calculated from the prime meridian, which runs north and south through Greenwich. The 0 degree longitude, the 0 degree longitudinal line passing through Greenwich City of England is called Greenwich Meridian. This one is Greenwich Meridian line called. So it divides Earth into two parts, east and west, east to west, and which are respectively known as the eastern and western hemisphere. The Greenwich line or zero longitude is known as the prime meridian. Second is international dateline. 180 degree longitude is called international dateline. It is just one longitude. The date and time changes when we cross this line. It passes through the Pacific Ocean. It is exactly not at 180 degree at the same place. It is in zigzag form. The reason behind it is that if it is drawn straight, it will cross some islands or at some countries, because of which two dates will mix up on the same island. In some places, while going to other side of an island, date may be changed, which will create confusion. To prevent this confusion, the line is divided roughly. To avoid any confusion of date, this line is drawn through the sea and not the land. The 180 degree longitude is known as the international date line. And the 180 degree longitude is only one longitude. So one day and date have to be added while crossing this line from east to west. Here is also one picture given, international date line. So here we can understand, while crossing this line from east to west, here is Monday and here is Sunday. So while crossing this line from east to west, same way, one day and date have to be removed while crossing this line from west to east. To come to western part, to come in east part, we have to also remove one date. So in short, we can say one day and date have to added while crossing east to west, and when we come from west to east, we have to remove one day and date. Thus, the dateline and the day and date change when this line is crossed. So to solve all the confusion, to avoid all of this confusion of date and day, this line is drawn through the sea and not at the land. Thank you for joining us.